Hey everybody, this is Nick. I got a question over on our how to edit data in PowerPoint charts, how to edit live data in PowerPoint charts from Foxy Mocha Kitten. And Foxy Mocha Kitten asked, sometimes I use the edit data to go in and edit the data, but sometimes those colored ranges, the pink and blue or the purple and blue ranges in the data source menu aren't there. So how do we update it when those color ranges aren't there? So in the video, we kind of look at those color ranges, that purple and blue color range that pops up in the edit data source window, but sometimes you're gonna edit a chart and maybe those aren't there. So let's go back to our chart and I'll kind of show you what I think is happening right here. So if you, there are many ways that you can go in and edit the source data from a live chart. So the way that we were doing it before was we were just right clicking on the chart and then click on edit data right here. You have two different options. You have edit data or edit data in Excel. If you click on edit data, just that source range might pop up. If I click on edit data, I'm gonna guess that just that little source range window is gonna pop up here. And sometimes you may have the pink or blue highlighted range, but I also don't have the pink or blue highlighted range right now. So I don't want that, so let's close out of that. Let's go back and use that other option, edit data, and then edit data in Excel. Oops, I clicked on edit data, I think I need to go back. Then I'm gonna click on that. Okay, right click, edit data, and let's say edit data in Excel. Now when you do that, the entire Excel document, the entire Excel file will pop up on your menu, on your screen. And you see, I still don't have the highlights, but what I do have is something different. I still don't have the highlights. I still don't have the highlights. And I still don't have a way to sort of edit this range. Now what we could do is edit, we know that this is still a dynamic table. So we could edit the dynamic table range by resizing the table. So I'm gonna click on resize the table and it shows you this is what I have in my table right now. Maybe I only wanna go down to July. So I'm gonna do row 13. So B13 or just number 13 right here is what I'm gonna type in here. I'll click okay. And now the table goes to that way. If I click on X out of this, now you can see my chart has updated only January through July. So let's try that again one more time. Right click, edit data in Excel. That menu is gonna pop up here. The data source will pop up. And you can see that the dynamic table is only encompassing down to row 13 because you see this little caret right here. That tells you that there is a dynamic table. If I click outside of that range, the table tab is gone. So if I click inside the range, the table tab is right here. I'm gonna click on table, I'm gonna say resize table, and let's bring back all of my data to 19. So I'm gonna click on 19 right here. Okay, now that little caret is back, and so now I've resized the table, I've included all of the data in my new table, click OK, and now you can see my chart has updated in the PowerPoint slide. Now another way that you can do this a little bit easier is go up to the chart design tab when your chart is highlighted here. Click on the select data button up here in this data menu. So click on select data. When you do this, the data source Excel file is gonna pop up, but you will also get the select data source range menu right here. Now this is where you can really easily update that. So right here in the data chart range, there's nothing here right now, but if I wanted to click on this little arrow sign, this is gonna say, okay, what is the new range that you want to do it? And this way I can manually click and drag to where I want it to go. So say I just wanted the years highlighted, I'll click enter. And now you can see on my horizontal axis labels here, there's just the years 2020 through 2023. So I'll click OK, and that's going to update my chart just for those years. And now again, magically, those little the highlighted ranges come back. So if I wanted to use those or work with those, I could. Or we could close out. Let's go back up to the data menu here. Click on Select Data. And the data source will pop up again, and let's manually drag to increase the size of that dynamic table. So I'm gonna click on the data source menu right here, and I'm just gonna click and drag, and we'll click all the way down. And we'll click enter. And I'll just scroll down here on the horizontal, so see, you can see the horizontal axis is right here. Click OK. Perfect. All right, so that should be one of the ways that you can go ahead and edit a chart when you don't see these pink and blue or purple and blue highlighted ranges. But if you ever want to kind of think about changing or reformatting your axis labels or anything along the horizontal axis, then always go up and check on that select data tab button right there, because you'll always be able to open that and you'll always be able to see that select data source menu pop up so that you can see what labels are on your horizontal axis and what labels are pulling for your, or what series is pulling for your vertical axis. So hopefully this helps. Foxy Mocha Kitten, let me know if it does in the comments. If you like this video, I hope you give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually Excel, PowerPoint, or Word. I love answering questions, so if you have a question for me, put it in the comments and I'll see if I can answer it and add it to my viewer question playlist. Hope you have a great day, and I can't wait to see you next time.